we want to go and have food. So we have a very interesting speaker coming up next. I'd like to introduce Mr. Atul Khanna. Atul Khanna is an entrepreneur who is connecting people, cultures, technology, often ahead of his time. He has been building enterprises in manufacturing, engineering, machine vision, life sciences, and now education by building an Indian-European knowledge corridor over the years. Very interesting to note, he has been knighted by the Finnish government and has received the Best Foreign-Owned Company Award in Sweden and a Lifetime Achievement Award from Deccan Chamber of Commerce. His first book, Between You and Me, Flight to Societal Moksha, is published by Bloomsbury. It ideates on fresh 21st century constitutional and governance ideas to harness the talents of 600 million young people under 25 years. I'd like you all to give a huge round of applause to welcome Mr. Atul Khanna.
Good afternoon, thank you. I have this very pleasant job to speak on a lovely topic. As we are so few of us, why don't you all come here? We can have a cozy chat. Come, come. Let's be front benchers for a change. The respected speaker after me is a great exponent of Vedanta. It's not my job to introduce her. She's in the audience, Jayaji Rao. And you'll learn art of living and more from her. But I want to ask you, what is your, when you hear the word moksha, mukti, doesn't matter, what strikes your mind? What strikes your mind? What do you understand to be moksha? Freedom from everything, freedom from death, please. Hanji? So, these are all true definitions. And timelessly, people like me, rightly, wrongly, have been taught that the greatest goal of human endeavor is to be free from the cycle of birth and rebirth and to find eternal moksha. And thousands of saints before whom I'm not even a speck of ant have expounded this and similar theories. And it has troubled me. Troubled me doesn't mean I'm right, but it has troubled me. That this is about, every journey is about the self. Even renunciation is about the self. Even moksha is about the self. And that's where I came with the idea of societal moksha. I love my life. It has had its tragedies, it has had its problems, but I love my life. I have the best family, best friends. I make friends easily. I'm well received. I really like my life. I'm not sure I want moksha from this life. What I do want is a society where justice, that is judicious, where there is no equality of outcomes, that is boring, but there is equality of opportunity. Where universalism does not mean financing public sector economic companies, is not locked in idealisms of left and right, but where universalism means universal access to education and healthcare. I'm not interested in left and right. Today, the state control of the left and the diminutive power of the human spirit, which is an integral part of the left, is unacceptable in the 21st century. Similarly, any kind of capitalism without a sense of social equity is unacceptable in the 21st century. So time has made left and right dance together. There is no room for ideology. There is room for good sense. These are the new pillars that will take us towards societal moksha. What would we do if we are drying our waters, we are finishing our air, the rich are getting richer, our indexes at human development or happiness are very, very weak. While personal attitudes may have a lot to do with it, but let's not forget the role of structural infrastructure, the role of good hospitals, the role of good cars, the goal of emission, the role of being able to enjoy water, swim without worrying about access to swimming pools, clean water to drink without having to buy pani. So these are my new models. I speak about them. Whether it is to 2 people, 200 or 2,000, I am happy to get any audience which will listen to me on that the biggest goal of life, far tougher to achieve, far greater than personal moksha. You like that? Luckily, what I am advocating has no interference with that. But you like that, please pursue it. But don't pursue it, or at least I would not recommend to pursue it to the exclusion of the goal of societal moksha. There is another aspect of societal moksha that is completely different from moksha as you understand it. And societal moksha counts on one thing that personal moksha doesn't, which is interdependency. It counts on teamwork. It counts on combining contradictions to create a total greater than the sum of its parts. And this changes man from being a soloist, which is fine, to being part of an orchestra. I think this definition, societal moksha, free and just society, the cobblestones to it, the asanas for it, the vision of it, the reorchestrating of society's tools for it, and making ourselves a participant rather than a recipient in its creation. Changing lament to being solution, in my view, is 21st century's greatest goal. In my view, all great goals move into philosophies. It is my prayer, dream, wish that societal moksha will get its center space in the third eye of mankind. You are much more learned than I am, and I'm most happy to take questions. Equalism, equalist I am, that doesn't mean equity exists around me. Equality to me is a personal virtue. Equity is a societal virtue. They are both, I don't want to get into wordplay out here, but social equity is different from leftism, is different from welfareism, is different from ideological leanings. Social equity can be practiced by a billionaire. It can be practiced by a guy on the street. Social equity is a deeper concept. You have answered the question better than I have. Equality is a relative concept, equity is a complete concept. Don't dump anything, don't even dump personal moksha. Add. The human heart is capable of loving so much that it doesn't divide, it multiplies. Add. I don't want to get into conflict, I want to jump over this, leapfrog over it into to build this. So therefore I don't want to cross the minefield of 17th, 16th, 15th, 12th, 11th, 9th century social ideas, and I want to jump into a space all on my own and draw on a clean slate. Any other questions? I only came to plant a thought. I didn't come to give a speech. Bolo Kusum ji.
What would societal moksha mean to today's youth in India?
I am a great fan of today's youth. I believe they practice it far more than we give them credit for and far better than preceding generations. So societal moksha in the context of today's youth, take your children, they are much more conscious about littering. No child I have ever seen spit pan. They are much more conscious about many, many things, about please, thank yous. So societal moksha is, if we imbibe it young enough that it becomes as natural to them as air, that should be our goal. Instead, we imbibe in them so much philosophy, economic, political, social, that they spent a lifetime unlearning. Then great scholars like Jayaji come and sort their minds out. So the whole process, by the time you are wise, 60% of your life is over. Try coming in earlier with a societal equity concept of societal moksha, and then this wide knowledge of the past is for you to pick and choose. Gautam Buddha, I'm not good with Sanskrit and speeches, but Gautam Buddha has a saying, I think it comes from some Vedas. He says, be your own light. If Gautam Buddha says, be your own light, don't even listen to me. Be your own light. Who am I? Who is anyone else to tell you what to do? But we can all tend to conclave around the bigger purpose of a free, judicious, pleasant society of equal opportunity. And then go for any moksha you like. If societal moksha is achieved, I think happiness in this life, if we can be that friend. To be a friend, to have a friend, you must be a friend. And if we can be a friend to society, society will be a friend to us. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Now I would like to request our associate director, Mr. Fariburz Irani, to kindly felicitate Mr. Atul Khanna with a memento. A round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.